Hey everyone, it's Dustin from Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about apprentice electrician tools. This is what every apprentice should start out with.
So this is my basic setup that I think that every apprentice should have. You want to have a good bag. I suggest you get a bag that you wear and a bag that you keep extra stuff in, because you're going to need all of this stuff at pretty much every job, especially when you're just jumping in and out of some guy's truck every day. And I would get a pouch that makes sure that you have this little chain on it, because then you can get electrical tape. You can put it on there and then you just pop it out when you need one. I like to get a belt that has a thick strap on it. The thin straps tend to just cut into your sides a little bit more. I always have a massive flathead. It's good for prying on things. Next on the list is a multi-tool. The one that I recommend that you guys get, it's a long shaft. This thing's cool because it's got flathead and Phillips, small flathead and big flathead. Small Phillips, big Phillips. This one actually has two square bits on it. It acts as a 5/16 nut driver and a 1/4 inch nut driver as well. So that's six different tools in one. You need to have a good sheetrock knife. Trade name we call these Klein's, but they're actually Lineman's pliers. Everything that I get is Klein tools. Another thing to get is side cutting pliers. I use these for like ripping staples out of stuff or cutting wire. I like these really small strippers. This will go from 10 gauge down to 18 gauge, and I like it because it's small and it fits right in your hand. These are still Klein, same kind of thing. These actually have the added function of being able to crimp with them, and you have threaders inside of here. So you can stick bolts inside of here, thread them in, and then cut them. This has the threading tool as well. It's got a cutting edge, it's needle nose, and it's got a stripper, so it's like multiple tools in one. You need to get a good multimeter. This is something as a brand new apprentice you don't really need to spend the money on. This is like $100 to $125. Really worthwhile to have. I mean, you can't be an electrician unless you've got a tester. This thing actually tells you whether or not you have a difference of potential between two wires, whether or not you have current on a wire, if there's continuity, you know, or if there's a break in the line. It tells you if there's a certain resistance on wire. I mean, it tells you a lot of things. So this is an actual tester. This is what electricians carry. Next thing is a square driver. Most of our like panels and screws, panel covers, devices, things like that, like they have the option of being flathead or square. These things are pretty cheap. It's a number two. The number two is worn off of here, but a number two square. This is a 3/8 nut driver, so 3/8 is a good one to have. But anytime you use anchors with anything, you're gonna want a 3/8 nut driver. And actually, I would just spend the time and go get like a full set of nut drivers that are all the way from like 9/16, 7/16, 1/2 inch, 3/8, 1/4 inch, 11/32. Those are the sizes that I'd get. A set of these little itty bitty terminating screwdrivers in Phillips and flathead are a really good thing to carry around. The other thing I've got on this side is a utility knife. You're gonna use a utility knife like all the time. Actually, every one of these things you're gonna use all the time. Next thing you're gonna use the crap out of is a tape measure. I would get a FATMAX tape measure. This helps you because a lot of the stuff that we do is overhead, so we're like holding tape measures over our head to try to measure things, and we need like 6 to 8 feet without this thing breaking on us. 25 feet is more than enough. Always keep a Sharpie, a marker on you, because you're gonna be marking stuff constantly. Another thing to keep on you is what we call a ticker, but this basically, like, you can go up to a wire and test whether or not the wire is hot or not. All it does is tell you whether or not there's power present or not, but it doesn't tell you which wire in a box is hot necessarily. But you always take your actual meter out after you've found something hot like that and test it. Don't just rely on these for an answer. Masonry bits and paddle bits. You're gonna use these a lot. These are for drilling into stone. Paddle bits, I would get something that gets you like 1/4 inch all the way up to about 1 1/4 inches. Get like a full set of them for $20. You can probably get like 10 to 15 bits. Get a 1/4 inch and a 5/16 drill nut drivers. You'll use the crap out of these. 5/16 more than anything. I keep a whole bunch of these different tips with, you know, one of them I'll keep with Phillips. Another one I'll keep with Torx or Star, whatever you call it. We call it Torx. One of them with a square, like a number two square. One of them with a flathead. You know, like keep several of these around you. A plug tester is another really good thing, and I would make sure you get a plug tester that has the GFI button on it. A headlamp. Electricians work often in really dark environments, so having a surplus of flashlights around, very, very good idea. If you want to be super zealous, you can get a UNIBIT. This is for drilling through metal. So it steps up, you drill a small hole, and that hole eventually just gets chewed out, and it becomes a bigger hole. This is another 6-in-1, but it's a stubby. It's got two different size Phillips, two different size flatheads. It's got a 1/4 inch, it's got 5/16. Next thing, a drill. There's an upper echelon of drills, and it's Makita, Milwaukee, Rigid, DeWalt. Okay, really good 18 volt, 4 or 5 amp hour, thick, sturdy drill. This has a hammer drill on it. I highly recommend getting that. Then I've got a small drill that I use as well in my pouch, and I can go around and take plugs and switches apart and things like that. It's really lightweight and really small. And then last but not least, I keep a separate bag of stuff. One of these bags, you can get 4 of these different colors for like 10 bucks at Home Depot, but I keep all kinds of different drill bits, all my paddle bits. These are really handy to have. This is like so you can attach a socket set to a drill, which is really handy. Having a good set of gloves, every electrician needs to have a level. Electricians and flashlights go hand in hand. But this is a bag that I carry everywhere, and it keeps all of this stuff in it, and then I bring that bag also. So I can carry in both hands everything that I need into a job. Another thing you need to get is Allen wrenches. Little trinkets and contraptions. This thing's pretty cool. You can stick that on a drill and get into a really tight place, and it'll actually drill with the Phillips at a 90. This thing's pretty cool too. Same kind of thing. You put a drill bit in there and it's flexible. You're gonna want at least 2 channel locks when you're doing pipe work. But anyways, that's it. That's my whole list of everything that you should need as an apprentice going into this.